A&E is proud to present an anthology of short films showcasing the dynamic new filmmakers who are shaping both the American and international cinema. From comedies to thrillers, welcome to our critically acclaimed collection of short stories.
An unfulfilled husband gets more than he bargained for with the purchase of an enticing gift as Short Stories presents Michael Palin in The Dress.
Raining?
No.
You must have dreamt it.
Mommy, I want the top of the mill. Yeah. Why does she always get the top of the mill? Well, I hope she can't hold the work for the center.
Seen something rather special I want to buy you. Can
Howard,
I see you soon?
Your breakfast's getting cold.
I can't stop now. I'll call you back, all right?
Come on now, Jane, get clear out. Mind your jumper. Come on, hurry up.
Bye, Dad.
Bye, Dad.
Bye-bye.
I've got brandy tonight.
Don't take some for me. What's broken?
Picture. Fell off the wall.
Did you pick up the glass?
Be careful where you put your feet upstairs.
When did we get that thing?
Darling, my parents bought it for us 3 weeks ago.
You're going to see them again this weekend?
So we're going to the party, aren't we?
The party? I thought we decided not to go to that.
Well, this time I've decided we are.
Oh. We are, are we?
Well, it's the first time Matthew and his sister have invited us to their place.
Well, maybe you should ask yourself why. Sorry.
It's beautiful.
Yes, it is. The colours sort of caught my eye. And it's so different from anything that you have.
I can hardly believe it. Just seeing you through the window like that. After this morning.
Yes. Oh, damn. Darling, can you fix my stud at the back? The usual bloody thing, it always gets stuck. You're not wearing that.
Why not?
Well, I think it's a mistake.
What do you mean?
It's just not quite right for where we're going. It's too loud.
Loud?
Well, you know, there's so many other things you could wear, much more suitable.
You don't like it?
No, I didn't say that. It's not quite right.
Evening.
Thank you. Now, why the hell does he want to live in a place like this?
Thank you.
Please, do go on upstairs.
Thank you. So gloomy, isn't it?
It's not so bad.
Well, I couldn't live in a place like this. Look at that.
I think it could grow on you.
It's fallen apart. The office doesn't look after it.
Ah, do come in. No difficulty finding us here.
It was worth the drive. What an extraordinary place.
Oh, Matthew, my wife.
Julia.
My wife, Julia. Matthew is the senior partner.
Oh, who was a junior partner, a brother? Howard doesn't tell me these things.
In fact, my father died recently.
Oh.
It's a partnership in name only.
I see.
Here, let me introduce you to Vera, my sister. Howard.
What are you doing embarrassing people like that?
Embarrassing who?
Remember, we don't have to stay too long.
Ah, now, Mrs. Gilmore, my sister Vera.
How do you do,
Anthony? Vera, this is Howard Gilmore.
Hello.
How do you do?
I do have something to drink.
Thank you.
It's quite warm, isn't it?
Oh, there's a balcony if you want to cool off.
But not unbearable.
Oh, be an angel. I'll be back in a moment.
Well, you old dog. Here, let me introduce you. Mark, I want you to meet Howard Gilmore.
Oh. Pleased to meet you.
Howard works at number 11.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm going there in October.
That's why I thought you should meet. We'll both be working on Hong Kong in general. Oh,
Very good. Hmm. Well, if you'll excuse me, do circulate, won't you, Howard, and let me know if there's anyone you want to meet.
Yes, I was just wondering where my wife had got to.
Oh, I'll find her. Let me take care of him, Mark.
You knew boy, huh?
Sorry?
Parker and Parker.
Oh, 8 months.
No, new boy.
Look after number one.
Howard Gilman, how do you do?
Hi.
Hello.
Thank you. What a curious piece.
It is. There's always a different way of looking at it.
Which side do you recommend? You like change.
So what does your husband think of our company?
Christy, why didn't you tell me you'd been invited?
Intrigue? Does it really matter? I'm here. She's not what I expected at all.
You should have had that dress.
It suits her. I expected someone more plain. Not at all like I'd imagined. Why don't we go somewhere we can be alone?
Yeah.
Why not? Rather exciting.
Are you mad? My wife is people.
See what's so interesting over there. Oh, Christy. Ah, the little red number. I think you'll get your fingers burnt there.
Good-looking woman.
I suppose. look here. Happened to find a bottle of Chateau Fleur Gouttier sitting idly back there. I thought it'd be mere gluttony to drink it all on my own.
In the old-fashioned way, would you stay in my heart? Just melt against my skin and let me feel your heart. Come close where you belong. Let's
Howard! There you are. Enjoying yourself, I hope. This is Harry Captain.
Howard.
You remember I was talking to you about him. He'll also be joining you on Hong Kong in general. And Mark, you already know, of course.
Ah, your wife.
I think it's going to be very exciting.
What?
Project. Oh, yes. Well, this is Harry Kaplan. We're going to be working together.
Yes, he was telling me. Darling, are you all right? You're looking very pale.
Yes, I think I'm going to guess
it. That has quite an effect on you.
Oh, I love this man.
What do you want to do?
Come closer. Forget all the others. It's nice to be like this, cheek to cheek.
You're not looking well, really. He's mad about that woman.
It's his wife.
Yeah, I'm scared.
No, I'm fine, really.
And we'll discover eyes we never knew before if we just close our eyes and dance along the floor. That makes me love you
Julia.
Howard, what are you doing?
We're leaving.
What's the matter?
We're leaving.
Howard!
We're leaving! Come on.
Shut up and get into the car. I've had enough humiliation for one night.
Only your fault, your ridiculous behavior. Making a fool of yourself in front of all those men.
Me? You threw a man home?
Not any man. A man who was dragging you across the
floor.
I could have killed him.
Oh, could you?
Bloody whore.
You don't understand. I have to face those people.
God.
What were you doing with that man?
Doing? I'll tell you what I was doing.
No, don't tell me. I don't want to hear. Just look at you in that thing. The Scarlet Woman.
You bought it for me.
Sorry.
Next on A&E, turn back to the golden age of television when a war bride loses husband and country but finds everlasting love in The Tweed Hat.